News 8's Weather on the 8s with meteorologist Joe Calhoun.
6:38, looking live on our Harrisburg Sky Cam. It is all quiet out there this morning and clear and calm, and yeah, it's on the cold side. 24 officially at Harrisburg International Airport. Winds are calm. Here's your News 8 Storm Team forecast for today. Mainly a sunny day. And after a pretty cold start, I think we double the numbers back up near 50 this afternoon. Then a cold night tonight, chilly, and down near freezing, maybe the 20s. And then tomorrow, this is west to southwest flow continues to keep us in the 40s to maybe even near 50 degrees. Fairly mild day. The winds will switch to the northwest late in the day. And I think as a front comes through, it's going to bring in some chillier air. Not real cold air at first, but it does get colder later on in the week. Right now, 20 in Selins Grove, 27 up in State College, 25 degrees in Oxford. Lancaster's at 23, 21 in Reading, 19 the York Thomasville Airport. But Lebanon's the cold spot at 18 at last report. Clear, calm, and yeah, cold out there. You don't expect anything on the radar on a clear morning. No clouds. A few wispy clouds up into New England. That's about it. You notice this little line of clouds here. That's marking a cold front. Keeping an eye on that. That's going to come through tomorrow, I think. There's some moisture down over Florida, and some of the computer models originally thought maybe this would come up and give us a snowstorm, but it doesn't look like that's going to happen because this front's coming in, and it's going to kind of shift it out to sea, push it away from us. Front gets close tomorrow, and it kind of filters through with maybe a few wispy clouds, but that's it. And it kind of trims temperatures just a couple of degrees, but even chillier air moves in behind that front. And then a storm out of the Rockies is going to head eastbound. It's going to be weakening, but it may give enough moisture to give us a little light snow or flurries, but I don't think it's really any impact, if anything, coming in as we go into the day on Wednesday. Then high pressure builds in after that. Now, those pattern changes I've been talking about. Most of this winter, we've had a kind of a westerly flow off the Pacific. Nothing tapping all the cold air up in the poles. Been very cold up in Alaska. You're reading about the cold air now over into Europe, and it's been cold over in the northern Atlantic. That's the reason the jet stream's been pretty straight. But we're kind of getting some wiggles in it. And what'll happen, we think, is warmer air this week is going to build in the west, going to tap some of that Arctic air into the east, especially by the weekend. But more importantly, mild air building over the North Atlantic. This is what we call blocking. The question is, how long does that hold in? Yeah, I do think it's certainly going to get cold, though, as we head toward the weekend. In the meantime, a mild start for the work week. Then a little bit of snow or flurries around on Wednesday. Shouldn't amount to anything because the temperatures are still too warm. Then we get colder. First chillier, then colder for the weekend. Question is, do we get any light snow or any kind of snow
right
with the colder air moving in? I think it'll hold into at least the beginning of next week. Question is this pattern going to continue and hold on for a while?
Right. Is it?
I don't know. I'll be honest. I really don't know if this is a long-term change or just a temporary change. The way this winter's been, I'd have to probably throw my money on not going to last.
Just not long-term.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking, too.
But,
I'm hoping.
But these are the first times we've seen these changes happening since last year.
Yep.
So
yep.
Okay.
It's
right.
Something.
All right, Joe, thank you.
Thank you, Joe. Well, coming